Well, hello there. Here we are on Sunday, June 28th, 2020, at 8:40 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. And that's in the United States of America, for those who don't know. And up here in our southwest sky, real high up there, we have a 57% lit moon up there, according to the Sky Safari Pro app. And tonight we're testing out the Nikon P1000, which I've been having problems with. And I'm not sure, but it might be working okay tonight. It wasn't earlier today, and it wasn't the other day, but... let me shut that information off. And we're out here near about the same time we were last night. And so far, the moon looks like it's coming in pretty well. Let me see where we're at here. I think this is about as far as we could go. 3,000 times 2 on the setup we had last night. Yeah, so far, it looks pretty good. But let's go in all the way. Yeah, those craters are coming out pretty nice. Okay, so we'll stroll around a bit. Yeah, it does look okay, but there's still some issues here with it. The colors it's producing is not, they're just way off the scale. And there's been some digital lines too that have become very prominent. Now the focus issue that I was having seems to be okay now, but even in the daytime I can see those digital lines. I had been noticing them even before that battery exhaustion fiasco happened. But yeah, it's looking okay. Let me get it to a size so I can get a clip of it. Okay, so there we go. As we can see, the clouds rolling over top of it. Gosh, there's motorbikes all around me, no matter what time of day. Yeah, I don't know what's up with the colors too on this camera. They've just gotten worse, especially the color blue. And they just seem to be so exaggerated here on the P1000. But again, I think it's all a part of the same problems I'm having with it. From the focus issues to the digital lines to the colors to oh yeah, I have a lot of audio problems with it. On most videos, I can't use the audio. And I have to use the audio from the little recorder here. I've been having that problem for, months now. And it's just gotten worse and worse. But still, it's a nifty camera. When it works. Okay, so let's wrap that up. And I might grab the other camera just to use as a reference. All right, there we go. I'm gonna go in and grab the other camera. I'll be right back. Bye now. Okay, and there we go. We're back out with the other setup of the Canon and the two teleconverters. And we lose a lot of stops of light, four stops of light, so it makes it f11, this f2.8 lens. But now that's as far as we can go in with this camera by using that 10x focusing zoom. And it's coming out okay. Still not as good as I would like, but we'll take a stroll around this one. Get up to our light beam area. And I'll tell you what, it's really hard to focus with this setup. Just the slightest touch of the focus ring and boy. Wow, look at that bunch of craters upon craters there in that one area. Now about the only other thing I can do is in Final Cut Pro, to go in any further, I could do a crop zoom. We might. We'll give it a shot. But I'm pretty happy with how well the moon has been coming out this time of day in a blue sky. All right, let me get a clip of that one. I'll be right back. All right, so we'll try to do some stacking in that Lynkeos app for Mac. I was really happy with how well the stacking came out last night with this setup. But anyway, that's a good enough look there. And so far, at least the Nikon's working. May not be at its peak, but it's working. In this Canon setup, it's heavy, but it's doable, so that's cool. Anyway, it's now 9:01 p.m. up here, so y'all take care. Bye from Ohio, says Jayling and Ohio Birdies.